just incredible. It was kind of hard to relate to because I did the painting 35 years ago. And it was really a very astonishing painting at the time. And I walked in, I just thought it was fantastic. And they all really look good, and they look fresh and new. And they could have been done yesterday.
But they weren't done yesterday. The Sister Chapel, a play on the Sistine Chapel, has been recreated at the Rowan University Art Gallery West. The last time the paintings were all seen together was in 1980. In the spirit of those times, it was a feminist artwork and a collaboration. 13 paintings by 13 artists.
It was conceived by an artist named Elise Greenstein in 1974, and she was trying to create a Hall of Fame for women. She sought out collaborators, a number of other women, and slowly different artists came on board, and together they developed a large-scale installation celebrating women's achievements.
The assignment was for each of us to do the idea, the epitome of our female hero, heroine. And of course, we had the size restriction that it had to be a full-sized figure on that size canvas. And I decided that a sister chapel should have a sister god.
Some of the artists came to the opening. Others are no longer alive. Betty Holiday painted the poet Marianne Moore. Shirley Gorelick chose as her subject the artist Frida Kahlo. Alice Neal, considered one of America's greatest painters, made a portrait of New York Congresswoman Bella Abzug in her trademark red hat. The artist Elise Greenstein, who conceived the idea for the Sister Chapel, created the ceiling.
It feels like sky. It's supposed to be like the journey through life, actually, the way the colors change. And of course, with the reflection, it reflects us and it also reflects the paintings. It's a wonderful conception. My painting is Durga, who is a Hindu goddess. I wanted something to represent not Western European background. I was very interested in Eastern religions, so it seemed like a natural thing to choose something which was already close to my heart, that I had some knowledge of, and also represent another part of the world. And I tell you, when I walked in and I saw her here, I thought, she looks really good.
Yeah, the artists are here and they're seeing each other and they're so happy and excited. It's like, really, it's like a reunion. You know, this was done over 30 years ago, and as far as they were concerned, no one was ever going to hear about it ever again. In their lifetimes, unfortunately, we've lost some of these artists already. And here they are seeing it, and they're just so thankful and just so delighted and so excited.
It's a very important period in the history of art. There's a great deal of work to be done. These women are not, they're not given the kind of attention they deserve. And this particular moment is passing into history. So if we don't preserve some of this now, we will lose it.
Professor Andrew Hoddle and gallery director Mary Salvante did more than just preserve the Sister Chapel. They helped to finish it. The tent was designed in 1976, but there was never the money to build it. It's now been constructed according to the original plan by Maureen Connor. And one of the paintings had been lost, probably destroyed. But Professor Hoddle was on a mission to recreate the Sister Chapel, and he wasn't about to give up.
He wanted me to recreate it. I had never thought of doing that. And so I did. I first did a copy. I projected the original, you know, and gridded it up, and I tried to do a copy, and it was just dead. It was soulless. It had no power. And I said, Andrew, it has to be much better. I've been working all these years. I still make a lot of art all the time. So I kept going down to Rowan, and Mary kept making it available, and I would just camp in the gallery, and we'd pull it out from storage, and I worked on it. Maybe I came down 4 or 5 times for 3 or 4 days, and I would work in there till 2 o'clock in the morning, you know, have food brought in. Andrew would come and bring me coffee, and I'd be running up and down the ladder trying to make it work, you know? And now I feel like I like it better than the original.
To me, it's the goal has always been about bringing this back and bringing it to the public, because it has to be seen to be experienced. Photographs just don't do it justice.
It's really thrilling to see it, really thrilling.
The New Jersey State Council on the Arts encouraging excellence and public engagement in the arts since 1966, is proud to co-produce State of the Arts with Stockton University, New Jersey's distinctive public university. Additional support is provided by the Geraldine R. Dodge Foundation,